strong one. Oh, and don't worry. I won't interfere with your training. I learned my lesson last time.
Wow, this does look strong. Let's just... Oh, come on! I can't even pull the bowstring back! How am I supposed to train with this thing? Caspar?
Hey there, Bernadetta. What's up?
Listen, I wanted to talk to you about all the stuff you're doing to apologize.
Oh yeah? Say, how's that training coming?
Lousy! So please, stop apologizing already!
What? But I softened up the training so it was way less than what I'd do myself.
Softer? What kind of training do you even do?
Well, for starters, I go 15 times harder than everyone else here. But of course, I don't have 15 times as many hours in my day, so instead, I do 3 times the amount, 5 times as fast. As for food, I generally need to wolf down about 6 times as much as everyone else because of how hungry all my training makes me.
Okay, you're not human.
Oh, and when I train with a bow, I use one with a string pulled 5 times as taut as normal.
Oh, right, I get it! Your training is ridiculous!
You think it's ridiculous? But my father came up with it, and he's the Minister of Military Affairs.
Well, if he's the standard you're aspiring to, then no wonder that's how it is!
Huh. You know, I never considered that my father got so strong because of how unusual his training regimen is.
I mean, I don't know about all that, but your routine is definitely not normal.
But I've been doing it since I was a kid.
Yeah, that explains a lot. Hey, good luck with that!
Hunger is the true enemy.
This is great! I bet anyone would love this stuff.
What in Folin possessed you to invite the two of us? It's fine, but why?
Yes, whatever nefarious scheme you're up to here, spit it out. Not that I mind, of course.
Come back whenever you're hungry. Hunger is the true enemy.
Hey, this is great. I bet anyone would love this stuff.
How did you know I like this? Yes, well, I admire people who show such consideration.
Oh, yes. This is definitely one of the foods I love.
Thank you.
whenever you're hungry. Hunger is the true enemy.
Solid. No. Did you really?
Oh, you did. This is my absolute favorite. Thank you.
Oh, I love this. Thank you very much.
Come back whenever you're hungry. Hunger is the true enemy.
Yeah, the flavors.
This is the best! Let's eat! Thanks.
Come back whenever you're hungry. Hunger is the true enemy. Come back whenever you're hungry.
Do you have a moment? Do you have a moment? Do you have a moment?
You're inviting me? Why? Very well.
Because I'm Batman.
This landscape is somehow nostalgic. The evil inside me and I are one and the same. Cursed swordsman, for whom there is no salvation. My mother and sister remain in good health. That is all I... No. Enough. I can sense that you and those maggots are of the same ilk. I will t-
Do you have a moment?
There's no time to waste. Where are you taking me? It feels as though time flows slower in open spaces like this. I had no idea you were the type to give flowers. I'll accept it, though. I find the mercenary lifestyle fascinating. It's a world that's so far removed from my own. I see. House Ordelia isn't descended from one of the 10 elites, but nonetheless, many of us have been born with crests over the years. You've made my day. If you could be reborn, would you choose to be a noble or a commoner? I see. For me... Why are you staring at me? Don't you dare say you think I look like a child. I take proper care of my hair, you know, just like any other grown woman. Oh. Would you like to talk? It's been a while since I've been able to relax like that. It wasn't half bad.
That's not true at all.
But... Oh, look who it is.
You really don't look like a kid. You shouldn't worry about it.
You think so?
Yeah. Now that I really look at you, I think you're a very pretty young woman. You act real mature, too.
Oh, you're just saying that. I'm not like that at all. Excuse me? Just what do you think you're doing?
Whoa! What's wrong, Lysithia?
You were speaking to a girl just now, correct?
Just now? Oh, yeah, I was. What about it?
Care to explain that line you fed her?
What? Did I say something weird?
Allow me to refresh your memory. Now that I really look at you, I think you're a very pretty young woman. You act real mature, too. You said the same exact thing to me, remember? I'm not a fool, you know. So what? You just go around spouting off the same lines to everyone?
Yeah.
Whoa, wait. Just calm down. I know that was wrong of me, but I do have an explanation.
By all means, enlighten me.
Just hear me out. You might have noticed, but giving advice isn't exactly my strong suit. And yet, for some reason, people always ask for my opinion on their problems. I never know what's best or how to respond. So I memorized a bunch of lines from some stories so that I'd at least have something to say. And it just so happens, one of those lines is complimenting a girl.
So what you said didn't come from you, but rather some fictional character?
Yeah, that about sums it up. I'm really sorry.
And then when people have asked for your advice, you've just parroted back some meaningless words. I can't believe you!
I thought it would be better than people getting mad at me for being honest.
Hearing the truth is always more preferable. So tell me now, what do you honestly think of me?
To be honest, half the time I don't even understand how I feel myself. But if I had to put it into words, I'd say... You make me smile when you're around. You're interesting, all the time. When I'm with you, it's like I never want to leave.
Oh. Is that so? Very well. I will endeavor to keep that in mind.
Yep.
I apologize for pressing you. I have matters I must attend to right now. So,
I wanted to tell her that she's fun and I never get bored around her, but it came out all weird. Ah, well. Hopefully she got it.
Unbelievable.
Wow, this is great.
Hunger is the true enemy.
Oh, right, he's gonna get it wrong.
Come back whenever you're hungry.
I'll do planning, bro.
Care to make yourself useful?
I've got nothing to worry about with the two of you on the job.
This will be a great chance to show me how much you've grown, Leonie.
I'd rather show you on the battlefield, but I'll do my best, Captain.
You've improved a lot, Leonie. Hardly had to lift a finger, huh?
I'm glad for the compliment, but I wish we could have worked together a little more. We all must do our fair share.
Again, Leonie. What is it today?
Seeing as you're strong as ever, Captain Gerald. I was hoping you'd train with me.
Your eyes are playing tricks. I'm an old man. I'd never be able to keep up with you kids at the rate you're improving.
You can't mean that. I'm nowhere near a match for you. But hearing that kind of praise from my hero makes me want to devote myself to training even more.
Aren't you a little old for childhood heroes?
Maybe, but I'm still happy. I worked my whole life to be a mercenary like you, after all. And now I get to fight at your side? Dreams really do come true.
I'm glad. It's not often childhood dreams actually come to pass. I recall you always scampering a few paces behind me as a kid. You'd stare at me and ask all kinds of questions, even when I was clearly too busy to answer.
Well, I was just hoping you'd teach me about martial arts and tactics and that kind of thing. Before your job ended and you left, I mean.
You couldn't have learned much. I wasn't there long. Yet here you are, standing strong and tall. You have no one but yourself to thank for that. You grew up without any guidance from this old captain. I'm glad to call you my apprentice.
Thank you. I promise to make you proud. And one day, I'm going to surpass you. That's my new dream.
That's the spirit.
And I'm not just surpassing you, but your kid, too. I had no idea they were so strong.
Guess the topic never came up when I was in Son. We've both been through a lot.
I'm jealous about all the time you two got to spend traveling together. I bet their strength is due to your instruction.
All I did was teach the basics of merc life. Natural talents likely behind the swordsmanship and tactical ability.
Which means normal folks like me have to put in 100 times the effort just to catch up.
Don't sell yourself short. I wouldn't have taken you on if you didn't have talent.
Huh.
Supplies are the lifeblood of any army. Everything has its use.
I carry a little of everything here. You've got an eye for quality, friend. Hope to see you again soon.
Come back soon.
time to make our move. Our troops attacking the gates have been instructed not to force their way in. Before long, the enemy will notice as much and realize we're already inside.
We need to locate and strike down the rebel leader. That should put an end to the insurrection. Along the way, you may encounter suspicious agents. They are the true masterminds behind the rebellion and must all be eradicated.
Got it. Now let's get going before those bloodthirsty monsters hurt any of the hostages.
I haven't been this angry in a long time. When is that man going to stop being a thorn in Her Majesty's side?
Ah, how splendid. But do try not to become so flush with rage that you make a foolish error.
Perhaps if you grew flush with rage every now and again, you wouldn't have the complexion of a coffin dweller.
Quiet, both of you.
You don't have to do this, Ferdinand. You can always stay back if you have doubts.
No. Fate put me on this path, and now I must walk it. Stay focused.
Enemy soldiers have breached our fortifications. To arms! Defend the glory of the Empire!
Our detachment is safely inside. We should wait to see how the enemy responds.
Start by seizing the inner ward.
These mercenaries are no better than common bandits. How could my father make a deal with such a pack of rogues?
Looks like this ain't your lucky day.
Expected an ambush.
Are
we
you
used
sure?
To play hide and seek here all the time.
It's Bernie's time to shine.
Initiating the operation. Let's go, everyone. It appears we have taken control of the fortress walls. Now we can move our catapults into position and attack.
Looks like they're here. And once we kill them all, we'll have more riches than we know what to do with.
must eliminate the caster in order to pass.
They only delay the inevitable.
We have the enemy where we want them! Unleash the arrows!
Get this operation underway, shall we? Starting the mission now.
So, what should I be doing again?
I feel like I already fucked up somewhere.
Business just doesn't do much for me.
So, what should I be doing again? Sure, let's try it.
Not a problem.
Initiating the operation. Let's go, everyone. Take a breather.
Are you sure? Hey, it's my turn.
I'll take this place down before you have time to strap your armor on.
Prepare to lay siege.
Go to work. Right then, let us go to work. Shall we join her?
My turn.
Right then, let us go to work.
It's Bernie's time to shine! I'm gonna help, okay?
Got it. Time to make
No more arrows!
Initiating the operation. Let's go, everyone. initiating the operation. Let's go, everyone. Initiating the operation. Let's go, everyone.
Not a problem. I've got this.
Sure, let's try it.
Well, it's magic walls or what have you. If you get in the way for Majesty, you will pay. Pathetic fools. And to think I was entertaining the idea of letting you scamper away.
Oh no, not the first gun.
Possess a magic construct.
Controlled by some kind of device.
Watch this!
This stronghold will fall!
The enemy's here! Kill them all!
Get in there and hammer while they're pinned down by that magic weapon!
Are you kidding me? Reinforcements? This day just keeps getting better.
Whoa! Okay, Leone, die! Like, Jesus!
Take a breather.
Okay.
Myself.
initiating the operation. Let's go, everyone.
Here I go. No mistake.
Are you sure? It's my turn.
Watch this.
Like, y'all, I swear, after all this shit I've been through today, I'm just so not motivated. It's tough. It's like, I can't catch a damn break. Like, one good thing has not happened to me in the past, I don't know how long.
There must be a second device. Keep looking.
Who gave these wretches leave to scurry in? Exterminate them.
Not if we exterminate you
initiating
first.
Initiating the operation.
Bitch.
Let's go, everyone.
Take a breather.
I don't know where the fuck I'm going.
I think that's the end of the reinforcements.
Yay!
Prepare to lay siege.
Yeah, no, guys. I'm just like, after all the shit I've been through the past, I don't know, few weeks, I'm just done. Like, I just don't have the motivation, period, to, like, do anything. And yet, I gotta do the things I gotta do. Everything else just is just like, nope.
I must outwit even death.
I just realized I didn't bring Ferdinand in. Oh no! I forgot to put Freddy in! No!
My turn?
Are you sure?
Here I go.
Hey,
I'll take over.
their next move will be.
But Thomas gave me that. Oh, I am so mad at you right now!
Would somebody please step up and do something about those other vermin there? They must learn who they're...
My turn.
The only way to rescue our detachment is by going straight through Kronja. But can we defeat her in time?
Hey, why do you wield that power, huh? Who even are you?
Why don't you tell me? You seem to know more than enough about it already.
You're done!
No. This is wrong. I can't die.
Yay.
I never expected much from those.
I forgot to bring Freddy in.
And here
I fucked up, man. Guys, I fucked up.
Hovering at my shoulder.
The rotting is under way, but those fools would sooner perish than admit it.
And the fire arms will rain death down upon them from above.
They must learn.
Fire orbs? Those must be new. A little ghost, if you ask me.
They look real dangerous, though. Also, what's a ghost?
Well, couldn't hurt.
I don't know how we made it, but we did.
Magic shield to safeguard our comrades.
Pay attention now.
Forgive my patience. The outer defenses only just fell.
Do it, Bernadetta!
He always show up at the worst possible moment and ruin everything. Viscount Fenya, Viscount Menya, forgive me.
I'm coming for you, Father.
The enemy no place to hide. Seize every key position in the fortress.
The enemy is getting too close to Duke Aya. We must hurry to inside.
It's not far too late.
Do it, Bernadetta. can stamp out those who slither in the dark.
Do it, Bernadetta! Enough. There is no escape for you.
Go on, then. I'll leave for you the final blow.
You leave me nothing. This was ever my burden to bear. Father! No. You are just a traitor now. In light of your crimes against the Empire, the punishment is death!
Send a runner to House Menya and have them deliver the letter I drafted. Also, take the soldiers under your command and begin investigating any magic constructs abandoned by the enemy.
At once, Lord Hubert.
It must be awful to end your own parents' life.
Come on, Ferdinand. Let's get going.
No. You may continue without me. I would like to stay here a moment. Just a moment longer.
Hubert, we have a messenger from the Alliance, and I need to know where our Western campaign stands. Ferdinand, may I have a word? I thought I'd let you decide how to punish your father's followers now that they've surrendered. Furthermore, this incident has led to the end of Fenya and several other noble houses. We need to settle the matter of the next Duke Eyre, and we need to do so quickly. So if you don't mind...
Is this your attempt at solace, Edelgard?
What?
I will punish the troops, and I will find a way to administer my father's lands. You can trust in me, Your Majesty. And thank you for considering my feelings in the matter.
To kill.
Wow, I did it.
I'll take what I can get.
I never expected we'd have our hands this full after returning from Fargus. Still, we've managed to quell the turmoil and maneuver our way back to Enbar.
Due to the valiant efforts of Count Burgles and his Aryan Road garrison, the key
Kingdom's counteroffensive has hardly put a dent in the Western lines. I wager the reinforcements reached them in time.
It's a good thing we do not have to maintain a large military presence in Leicester. But of course, that was Her Majesty's plan all along.
We'd be up to our shoulders in trouble if we hadn't settled hostilities with the Alliance.
Do you think people in the Empire will be all right? I'm worried about the Opera Company, of course, but I'd also be devastated if anything happened to my friends in the capital.
The end result of all this was the complete expurgation of the Empire's remaining dissidents. In a way, we should be thanking them for handing us this opportunity on a gilded platter.
Adrestia deserves some stability for a change, so I think it's good that Her Majesty has total power now. With the opposing nobles wiped out, it's a breath of fresh air after the way things were under the old Emperor.
Lynn, think about who's here.
It is all right, Dorothea. I have moved on.
It's funny, though. I was sure my father would take part in the rebellion, but he just didn't. I mean, I feel like all he ever did was complain about Her Majesty, you know? I guess he was so scared of the church that he decided to stay holed up in Garret Mach.
What is our next action, Lady Edelgard? If we are returning to the Western Front, I will have preparedness.
Fighting your own people sure takes the thrill out of battle. So let's go wall up the kingdom instead and put an end to all this. Who's with me?
All that remains is for Adrestia to claim victory.
And along those lines, I wish to present an idea. One last stratagem to ensure that we prevail.
We were successful in striking down Cronia at Fort Mercius. However, Lord Arendelle, which is to say Talus, remains at large, and any schemes Solon may be plotting are so much conjecture in the wind. Still, his efforts in Rim territory effectively empowered the late Duke Eyre to stage a coup. Whatever the case, he must have a very good reason for seeking to prevent the kingdom's fall.
But why would they help the people who are harboring the Archbishop? It makes no sense. Unless their aim is simply to prevent the war from ending by any means possible.
We know the kingdom's court mage, Cornelia, is connected to those who slither in the dark. They may have planted other associates in Fargus as well. If they already have the king's court dancing on strings, it stands to reason they would focus their attention on obstructing the Empire.
I agree the theory hangs together, but does that mean we should expect more interference?
We should, Your Majesty. Though I would at least like to think they no longer have anyone left who can act brazenly in the open.
And need we worry about our mercenary friend?
I was under the assumption that they had your implicit trust.
Absolutely, but not enough to purge all of the doubt from my heart. I once trusted my uncle, as well as the late Duke Eyre, and he wasn't even replaced with a doppelganger. People who come in contact with those who slither in the dark are not the same afterward. How am I to trust anyone in a world where such a thing can happen?
I do not disagree, Your Majesty.
Yes, well, we must remain vigilant until the war is over for good and all. Although I wonder if we can rest easy even then.
We still don't really know much about Solon, Cronia, and Talus. I was thinking this would be a chance to learn about my power, or who you actually are. But, oh well.
Oh well? Is that all you have to say for yourself?
I mean, I'm still curious, but my attention right now is on the battles ahead. And hey, it's not like knowing the truth would change much for you anyway. Even if I am related to those slithering people somehow, it's not like I'd want to split up with you.
That's music to my ears. It's incredible to see just how fast you've matured. Makes me proud to call you my partner in destiny. Is this what being a parent feels like?
Yeah, I guess. Anyway, this war will be over soon, so let's do what we've gotta do to see it through together. I'll be counting on you, Arval.
Scarlet Blaze.
Oh shit,
torment,
we're at this chapter.
Of the eagle and lion. Edelgard succeeds in containing Ire's insurgency, and while she is concerned by the absence of the nefarious Tallis, she prepares her army for the next step regardless. The time is nigh to crush the kingdom and Central Church's growing momentum and put an end to the war once and for all.
I've gathered you here in Garrick Mach because the time has come. We are returning to the front.
Oh yeah, I've been waiting to hear that forever. Let's go wreck things!
For the next phase of our campaign, we'll be working with the Alliance's leader, Claude, to tighten our cordon around the kingdom. Rather than try to advance on the Western Front, we'll join forces with the Alliance and press in from the east.
This means we'll be marching northeast from the monastery and infiltrating Galatea.
I hope we can finally end it this time. I don't think I can deal with doubling back again.
Agreed. This slog has slogged on long enough.
Worry not, friends. I'll not be blindsided twice. I promise you that. We won't rest until all of Fodlan is united. We will fight tooth and nail for it, and we'll do so together.
So, we're finally dusting off our armor and going somewhere, huh? You must really want to end this war if you're letting the two of us loose on the kingdom.
Quite right, Captain Geralt. We will not accept anything less than the fall of the royal capital. You and your mercenaries will be marching with us. This is not a problem, I trust.
Let's just say I have a history with someone at the capital and leave it at that.
Yeah, Brad.
But if the time's come for me to sort that out, so be it. In any case, we're ready to go, right, kid?
We'll earn our keep. Gotta say, I'm excited to be fighting with you for a change.
We made some headway on the Western Front once the Empire pulled its main force back.
What does it matter when their Minister of Military Affairs still holds Aryan Road? Even if we were in a position to keep throwing troops at those walls, we're never going to crack them.
But if we keep digging our heels in here, their main force will be on us again in no time.
It appears they have already dealt with the insurrection at Fort Mercius. If they don't come at us from the west, they'll soon waltz right in from the east.
Might I offer a suggestion, King Dimitri?
Of course, Lady Rhea.
We should retake Garrick Mach. It is the only way to reverse our current fortunes. If I call upon the Church's faithful, they will come running from every corner of Fodlan to liberate the monastery in the Goddess's name. With Garrick Mach under our control, we will be able to keep the Imperial Army in check. Additionally, it might convince some of the more fickle Alliance lords to reconsider their loyalties.
I mean no disrespect, Lady Rhea, but this proposal hardly seems...
There is more. As you know, the Bishop of the Southern Church is currently seated at the monastery. If we remove him, it reminds the world anew that Archbishop Rhea is the rightful head of the Church of Seros. I believe this will shake some of the more devout Adrestian lords from their Emperor's grip. While their faith may waver now, Adrestia is still the cradle of the Church of Seros. There are yet many pious believers among their nobility. If we can pull them to our side, it may shift the war back in our favor.
We should strike while the iron is hot. I will get the word out at once.
Hold, Lady Rhea. While I now concede that your plan to retake the monastery has some merit, I must ask that you alert no one.
And why not? I need only say the word, and an army of believers will flock to our cause.
Yes, and the moment the enemy spies people flooding in from across hill and dale, they'll realize what we're planning and bolster their defenses.
Is Dimitri starting to doubt Rhea? Interesting.
You believe their defenses are mightier than the faith of the people? By the goddess, have our enemies truly become so powerful?
Is Dimitri starting to doubt them? Holy shit.
In that case, what do you propose?
We entrust the eastern lines to houses Karen and Galatea, then ride in mass toward Arian Road. The enemy will think we intend to assail the Silver Maiden, but instead, we break east.
East? Then we'll be attacking the monastery through the Valley of Torment. I get your thinking now. If we attack from the west, Arian Road would be at our backs, and the Empire could box us in.
Very well. I have no objections. My church members will assist in guiding your soldiers through Aelan. The monastery is holy and precious to us, and by the name of the goddess, I swear, it will be ours again.
Good. Then I'll ready the troops. Lady Rhea, Sedith, I place all of our futures in your hands.
Giant waste of everyone's time, but
what if we tried this? Just leave everything to me,
shall we?
I will ask Edelgard to handle this matter. As for this one, it seems as though I have no choice but to do it myself. If only I could spare the time.
Hey, Ferdinand. You should probably think about getting some sleep. That's an order, actually, from Hubert. But I agree with him.
My apologies. My list of responsibilities has grown rather unwieldy of late. Exhausted as I may be, I will be done here shortly. You need not fret.
Ferdinand, come on. I thought you were supposed to be giving everything your all. If you're really that tired, how are you going to be in any shape for what's coming tomorrow? Go on and give your all to a good night's sleep.
Yes, you are right. How could I, of all people, not realize the error in my ways? I shall take that to heart.
Glad to hear you're coming around. Oh, and finish fast, okay? Here, I'll even help. I don't want to go to bed just to find out you stayed up all night working. Let me just...
Wait.
Hmm? What's up?
Never mind. Thank you for the concern. I will be sure to convey my gratitude to Hubert later as well.
Don't forget. He's really worried about you, you know?
Is he now? Usually he finds any occasion to criticize me.
Same here.
Is that so? Dear, I thought he had taken a shine to you.
If he has, he sure doesn't show it.
Ah, before I forget, what would you think about coordinating our schedules tomorrow? I've been so absorbed in my work of late, we've scarcely had the chance to spend time together. I have been pouring all of my effort into rising early, training, eating, and in the process, I have neglected our friendship. As fellow advocates of giving one's all to all of life's pursuits, I say we work together to draw out each other's dormant potential.
Wow. Works for me. My schedule's pretty light these days. It'll be good to spend some time together, but just so we're clear, we are not on the same page with this whole giving our all thing.
Three, four more chapters?
Splendid!
We got this one.
This should serve as all the motivation I need to continue pressing onward undaunted. And with that settled, I believe it is time for us to devote ourselves fully to a tranquil slumber. Come, our lump-riddled camp beds await our zealous efforts.
Okay, this time you are joking, right? It's seriously impossible to tell with you sometimes.
We have this one, Tormented of the Eagle Lion, and then we have chapter 15. Yeah, we actually got like two more chapters after this. All right, guys, I'm gonna go stop.
You're in better spirits than I expected. You look at least two shades less pale than you did after the battle at Fort Mercius.
Oh, but your majesty does enjoy telling it like it is. Would it be the end of you to show a little compassion? No. Then you would just be pitying me. I do not know which is worse. Regardless, I am well. Thank you for noticing. Ask of me what you will, and I shall see it done.
I don't need anything from you, Ferdinand. Or at least not in that way. Just give me your usual effort, and that should be enough to get us through the upcoming battle.
You can count on me. Point me at a foe, and I will dispatch them with all haste. I cannot afford to die now, or my page in the history books will end in a most horrid fashion. Plagued by the guilt of striking down his father, Ferdinand welcomed the cold embrace of death on the battlefield. Or some such hogwash. Yes, I killed my father. And I would be a liar if I said it did not wound me nearly beyond reckoning. But I will not hate myself for it. It was the correct choice. I did the right thing.
Well, don't feel too bad. Imagine what they would write about me if we lose this war.
despite her futile attempts to wrest power from the Prime Minister, the Emperor's people turned against her and her life ended in abject failure. The end. I know exactly what the world would say of me, which is why I have no intention of losing.
I will not permit such a thing to happen. If ever my life were to be weighed against yours, I would gladly perish in ignominy if it meant keeping you alive and well.
Huh.
What? Did I say something amusing?
No, it's just... you're so strong, so proud. If all the world's nobles were like you, there would be no need to dismantle the aristocracy. That's all. I know it's a futile thought.
Nothing is futile. Though even I must admit it seems to be so, given the circumstances. Still, you vastly underestimate the potential of the aristocracy. For generations, our ancestors worked hand in hand, sharing knowledge and wisdom to administer our great land and ensure it was well protected. They acquired knowledge of the region and developed good policies to rule it. And in doing so, they earned the trust of the people. We cannot throw away everything they have built. It would be folly.
Of course not. What do you take me for? I'm dismantling the aristocracy, not their legacy. The common folk will take up the torch and carry on.
Do you believe they are ready? No matter how gifted they may be, they are only commoners. In order to replace the nobility, they need to be educated. Wait a moment. I see your plan now. You intend to establish a school. One that is not merely for nobles and wealthy merchant children, like the Officers' Academy once was. A school where anyone can enroll, regardless of wealth or standing, and get an education rivaling that of any noble.
Ferdinand? I cannot begin to guess where that idea sprung from, but this is exactly why I need you beside me as we shape the future of Adrestia.
You mean to say that you did not actually... So I was? Well, it is nice to be needed.
What is Talus plotting? Will the capital be all right? If another imposter... Hmm? Who's there?
Lady Edelgard? Is that you?
Bernadetta? What are you doing here at this hour?
Oh, well, I was maybe sort of hoping to hole up here for a while. This is one of my go-to spots when I want to be alone.
In that case, I apologize for intruding.
Oh, it's really not a big deal or anything. Lady Edelgard? Is everything all right? You seem, well, kind of down. If something's bothering you, I'd be happy to listen. If you don't mind talking to me, I mean.
Thank you, but I wouldn't know where to begin. Once the Emperor starts rattling off her many woes, you're likely to be trapped here forever.
Actually, that isn't what I meant.
Then, what did you mean?
Do you remember that time you told me how my curse was lifted? And then you started to say that yours was too? Well, I've been worried that curse has been eating away at you the way mine did with me. Is that why you're here all alone in the middle of the night?
I wasn't expecting you to see right through me quite so easily. But you're right. Something is eating at me. There is an enemy I thought I'd fought and beaten, which I believed freed me from my curse. Alas, that was wishful thinking. My enemy is still alive. And worse yet, he is not alone.
That sounds terrible, but I know how that feels. I've been struggling too. If I stay outside too long, I end up being seized by this panic that makes me want to hide away again. I guess I'm still learning how to deal with it.
That's how life is, Bernadetta. We all bear our scars, but the only thing we can do is keep going. The idea that nestling up to someone and being kind will make all of their pain disappear is nothing more than fantasy. That's simply not how such things work.
A mean old world, that's for sure.
But that's no reason to despair. After all, what are we fighting for but a world in which people are no longer left with scars like yours and mine? A world in which the people who wish to stand out can do so, while those who remain on the sidelines have their choice honored as well. That is the future we're building together.
Do you really think we can do it? Because if you do, I'm going to fight right alongside you, and then celebrate by locking myself in my room.
I'd say that's perfectly acceptable, so long as you've taken care of the things you need to do.
Aww, but doing things is the hard part. Stop being so difficult, world.
Aww. Alright, we're just gonna talk to everyone, guys, and then I'm just gonna end stream. I'm just not feeling a bunch of shit.
Do you have a moment?
You sure?
Right. That's very kind of you.
Let me think. preferences. Clever.
Alright, we're gonna give the Marcosa to Joey. Now I can find Joey.
Hey.
Or maybe we should leave it for the last chapter, for the final chapter.
Understand what this means, right? Here, take it. And you'd better not lose it.
Sorry, Lenhart.
Are you busy? Sure. Now this is simply delightful. Nope.
must be telling you. This is giving me great joy. Dreadful.
Hi there.
What do you think? Appreciate it.
This is lovely.
Sure.
disappointing.
I respectfully decline. How thoughtful.
You know. My, how troubling.
Take it.
It's you. And that's it. Thanks, I suppose. Thanks, I suppose.
That makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
No way.
Okay. This is...
No way.
Okay.